Hey guys, this time for your viewing pleasure, it's simply me going to show off to you a little bit about all the cool things I've been able to do with the computer and JMRI. So after a whole bunch of fun little programming, I now have the ability to track my trains, do block detection, and get ready for signaling and all that. You can see there, as a train moves along, it occupies the block, turns it red, all this other stuff. Also, as you may or may not be able to hear, I can throw switches. So to create a panel, we go to the Panels tab, go down to New Panel, and then we go down to Layout Editor. We get this new little window, and we can start laying out our track schematic. So we want to add a right-hand switch. We'll just have this selected right there, as you can see. You'll hold down the Shift key and click, and your switch will show up. To add a track segment, you can go ahead and what I do is, in this case, I'll need an anchor point because the track segment needs two ends to connect to. So I'll choose a little point right here. I'll hold down the Shift key and add the anchor point. Kind of see right there. Then we'll go up here to track segment. It's kind of the top right of the screen here. Then we'll go over here, put the mouse over it, hit and hold the Shift key, click and drag, and you have added a track segment. And one small note, if you already know the turnout name or the address of the turnout, you can actually, before you add it or, you know, shift, click it in place, you can enter the turnout name here and then select which turnout you want to add and do that following process. There's turnouts, there's sensors, and all these other little options. Mostly what I've done is turnouts. These three, more than three, these switches are from the, these are the DigiTracks, they're on all. So if I go to LocoNet, you'll see that these guys are part of the DigiTracks. If I go over to NCE, you see the switches I have in the NCE system. The way it works, is down here, you have an add button. You press it, and you enter the hardware address and your username, making sure you have the right system selected. Programming the Switch8 Mark II is actually really easy. You go ahead and you press this button here, the select output. That'll light up an LED. I'll just go ahead to the first one again. Then you click over here, the program output. It'll flash P, come to your controller, hit select accessory. I want address 101. I'll hit. So you can see all the switches. If I say control click this one and click edit, you can see that I assigned this turnout name. This is turnout 103. The NT stands for NCE turnout. That's JMRI stuff. So you enter this information for each turnout, and that's how JMRI knows which switch goes to what turnout. One thing I should, next part, when adding sensors, for the NCE AIU01, what you do, the easiest way to do it, is there's a little math equation you could do or whatever, but what I've researched and found out is you take the hardware address, so in this case the hardware address of the AIU01 is 10, you put in a little semicolon, and then you put in whatever the port number is, if you will. So say the BD20 is in screw terminal number 9, you do 10, the semicolon, and 9. And then you can give it a username. I've just been going BD9. And then you click OK. Now, what it will automatically do is figure out that math for you. So, the sensor is actually NS152. So, that is what you would put in here when you do the control click edit for a block. So, block 4, sensor, the username is BD9, so you just select that. Now for the NCE USB interface, there's, you know, a few settings here and there. You can do, for one example, the baud rate I'm leaving currently at 9600, or 96,000, excuse me. Oh wait, that is 9600, never mind. Anyway, so the baud rate is 9600. You can go up to 19200. That requires a lot of different setting changes, so we won't do that yet. But the system manufacturer is NCE, system connection NCE USB, and for whatever reason, so you know, I choose version 7 because that's the board I have now, and for whatever reason, the system JMRI kept requesting me, whether I put it on power cab or SB5 is which what I have, it wanted me to put it on the Power Pro. So I did. Everything works fine. So I guess that's kind of just a JMRI thing. I'm not sure about that. All I know is these connection settings are working. That being said, another connection setting for the USB board are the jumpers. So here we have both the USB boards, one for the LocoNet, and the flashy one is for the NCE. The way I have this set up for version 7 and an SB5 Smart Booster for a baud rate speed of 9600, I have jumper 3 here, you probably can't see that, but jumper 3 is in the on position. There's little jumpers and you put them on. If I want to bump up the speed, I would take off jumper 3 and put on jumper 4. As I said again, or will say again, there's a bunch of other connection settings I'd have to do at the computer to set everything to 19600. So I'm just leaving it as is for now.